For the past year or so, I've been doing science on this little thing, a beetle larva picked from under the bark of a dead tree. My collaborators and I started working on it when we noticed it does something extraordinary and unexpected, something that hasn't been documented before. It does this. So a lot of insects jump, and a lot of them do it way better than that beetle larva. But what's extraordinary about that footage is how weird it is. There are over 350,000 beetle species in that same suborder, and before this, none of those larvae were known to be able to do that. This is the adult form of that beetle, a lined flat bark beetle. Adults like the larva have a flattened body and can be found under the bark of dead trees where they feed off of fungus. The adults don't jump like the larvae do. This is where we found all the beetles we worked on, a dead tree in the middle of NC State's campus. We luckily pulled enough larvae from this tree to do a complete study before it was thrown into the wood chipper. For scale, the average body length of a larva in our study was about 5.5 millimeters, which is about the width of a pencil. And here's the adult on the tip of my finger. These are small beetles. So the first thing to do with some unexpected behavior like this is to describe what exactly is happening and then try to figure out how the insects are doing it. Here are what jumps look like in real time. The beetle stops walking, arches its back, and flings itself forward. It's too fast to see with a normal camera, so here are some of the jumps we captured and analyzed by filming at 3200 frames per second. A typical jump launches the beetle forward in an arch. As they get into the air, they curl their bodies into a circle and hit the ground bouncing and rolling. We were able to capture and analyze 29 jumps, and a jump can move the beetles up to about 4 body lengths in distance and 3 body lengths in height. Whenever a tiny animal like that is doing something really fast, like throwing itself into the air, it's possible that it's using a power amplification system, which means instead of moving its body through direct muscle action, it's using its muscles to load some sort of spring that can be instantaneously released into one explosive, fast movement. So, part of figuring out if that's what's happening is to measure how much muscle the animal might be using to power its jump. To do that, we made a micro CT scan of one of the larvae. From that scan, we could segment and separate out all the muscle tissue in the body. And then we were able to estimate that 9.7% of the total body mass, or 0.12 milligrams of the beetle, was muscle. We could take that muscle estimate and pair it with takeoff velocities from our high-speed footage. On average, at liftoff, the beetles are traveling at a speed of about 0.5 meters per second. So, even if we overassumed that 100% of the muscle mass is involved in powering a jump, some of the jumps we recorded exceeded the maximum known power density of muscle tissue. That was proof to us that these beetles are performing power-amplified, spring-loaded jumps. Figuring out that these jumps were spring-loaded was cool, but the thing about spring-loaded animals is they usually have a specialized piece of anatomy that they use as a latch to hold the spring in place and then instantaneously release that stored energy. Take another beetle for instance, the click beetle. Their spring-loaded jumps are only possible because of this structure here, a peg that keeps their body locked in position while an internal spring is loaded. When that peg slips, the energy that was built up in the spring is released all at once, sending the beetle up into the air. With our beetle larvae, there was no obvious anatomical latch. We looked for one with a scanning electron microscope, imaging the beetle from head to tail. We looked at parts that might have anchored the beetle to the ground while it loaded its spring, and it all looked like normal beetle bits to us. Going back to the high-speed camera, with ground-level close-up shots, we could see that the beetles had their legs stiff, gripping the ground when they're arching their bodies and loading their spring. Going frame by frame, we saw that when the first leg slips, the beetle loses its grip, and that triggers the release of the stored energy and the start of the jump. To verify that no other fast movements were setting off the launch sequence, we filmed some jumps at 60,000 frames per second, and they showed the same thing. The grip the beetle's legs have with the ground works as their latch. It holds them in place while they load up for a jump, and then, when the grip is released, that sets the whole jump sequence into motion. Considering the power amplified jumps of other insects like click beetles or plant hoppers, what these larvae do is slow and unimpressive. But what makes it interesting is this spring-loaded system works seemingly without any specialized anatomy. So while documenting the fastest and most impressive is exciting, sometimes looking at the other end of the scale can be just as scientifically interesting. Okay, there's one other aspect of this research story that I want to share, and it has to do with YouTube. Over a year ago, I put out this video about jumping fly maggots. The maggots in that video were collected from the same dead tree as the beetles in this one. I would have done a whole research project on the maggots, but I didn't manage to collect enough individuals before that tree came down. At the end of this video, I put in a few shots of the beetle larvae jumping and said that we are currently working on a project with them. Well, a researcher working on this family of beetles over in Japan watched this and recognized the species. He reached out and sent over these unpublished clips of a related genus doing the same jumping behavior. So, thanks to YouTube, we gained a co-author for this work and are also able to say that this jumping behavior is probably widespread in this group of beetles all across the world. We just submitted everything I just showed you for publication as a peer-reviewed science journal article. It's under review now, but you can read the draft of the work by looking up the preprint, which we linked in the video description below. Thanks for watching.